Yeager's supersonic flight compares with the Wright Brothers' original powered flight as a milestone of civilization. The course of subsequent aerospace development depended as surely on Yeager's revolutionary flight as previous aeronautics had relied on the Wright Brothers' pioneer efforts. Born in Myra, West Virginia on February 13, 1923, Chuck Yeager acquired a taste for marksmanship and machinery at an early age. Skilled in both areas, he enlisted in the U.S. Army Air Corps in September 1941, where he became an aircraft mechanic. In July 1942, with a new war demanding prodigious quantities of pilots, Yeager was chosen for enlisted pilot training. Graduating as a flight officer, an aviation grade similar to a warrant officer, in March 1943, he was next assigned to the 357th Fighter Group. Training continued in streamlined Bell P-39 Era Cobra fighters in the high desert near Tonopah, Nevada. At Tonopah, Yeager honed his skills in the P-39 and watched as some of his fellows paid with their lives as they tried to master high-performance aircraft. It was a deadly serious winnowing process that was remorseless in its selection of graduates to send forth into combat. Chuck Yeager's combat debut came February 11, 1944, in an uneventful fighter sweep over the coast of France in a powerful P-51 Mustang. Shot down on his eighth mission, Yeager used his wits to avoid internment and his moxie to convince General Dwight Eisenhower to permit him to return to combat instead of rotating home, as was policy for downed flyers. By war's end, he had earned ace status by downing 13 German warplanes, including five ME-109 fighters on a single day. The unique Yeager formula for survival made use of his proactive confidence, mechanical savvy, and an intuitive sense of the cadence of all kinds of aircraft right out to the limits of their performance. By July 1945, Yeager was posted as a maintenance officer in the Air Force's Flight Test Division at Wright Field near Dayton, Ohio. Yeager's mastery of aircraft soon came to the attention of Flight Test Division Chief Colonel Albert Boyd and Boyd's deputy, Colonel Fred Ascani. In 1946, Yeager graduated from Flight Performance School, the equivalent to today's U.S. Air Force Test Pilot School. In 1947, Colonel Boyd, an accomplished test pilot and demanding leader, decided to assign three relatively unknown young pilots to the test program that shaped the very future of the Air Force and of aeronautics, the assault on Mach 1, the speed of sound. Captain Chuck Yeager was to be the pilot of the rocket-powered X-1 research aircraft, with Lieutenant Bob Hoover as his backup and chase pilot. Captain Jack Ridley, a first-rate flyer, gained notice as a brilliant test engineer, the role Colonel Boyd chose for him on the X-1 program. After familiarization and incremental speed buildup flights inched closer to the perceived sonic wall, on October 14, 1947, Yeager flew the thin-winged orange X-1 beyond buffeting transonic phenomena out to a record speed of Mach 1.06 at an altitude of 42,000 feet. In so doing, he dispelled the myth of an impenetrable sound barrier, verified aerodynamic innovations necessary for flight into the supersonic region, and opened the way for production jet fighter aircraft that would fly supersonic only half a year later. Yeager's role as a record-setting test pilot continued. On December 12, 1953, he set another record by attaining Mach 2.44, 1,650 miles per hour, in a silver X-1A. It was on this flight that Yeager encountered a new and terrible phenomenon that replaced the old demon of compressibility as a threat to sonic pioneers. It was inertial coupling, a devilish blend of aerodynamics and mass, that tumbled the X-1A out of control as it fell 40,000 feet as Yeager struggled and succeeded in saving himself and the X-1A to fly another day. Even as he probed the frontiers of flight in research aircraft between 1947 and 1954, Chuck Yeager also evaluated a parade of production aircraft, beneficiaries in many cases of his pioneering supersonic flight. During one particularly hectic month, Yeager logged flights in 27 different types and models of aircraft. In October 1954, Yeager returned to the operational side of the Air Force, commanding fighter units. He became commandant of the U.S. Air Force Test Pilot School at Edwards, then called the Air Force Aerospace Research Pilot School, in 1962, next assuming command of the 405th Fighter Wing at Clark Air Base in the Philippines in July 1966. While at Clark Air Base, Yeager returned to combat, flying 127 missions over Vietnam. Several years and assignments later, General Yeager completed his illustrious Air Force career as director of the Air Force Safety and Inspection Center at Norton Air Force Base, California. He retired on March 1, 1975, after 34 years of military service, during which he logged more than 10,000 flying hours in over 330 different types and models of aircraft. Yet, in a sense, General Yeager did not retire. In the decades since 1975, he has frequently returned to Edwards Air Force Base to fly with different squadrons and crews as a technical advisor to the Flight Test Center commander, setting an example for others to follow. It has been an Edwards Air Force Base tradition to commence the annual October Base Air Show with a sonic boom made by a jet piloted by Brigadier General Chuck Yeager, USAF, retired.